sometimes it's no use. I think and I try, but I'm dry, no juice. But I've got a little secret for knocking the flow loose. When I can't write, I eat produce. Yes, I eat fruit when I've got the writer's block, or I eat veggies when I've got the writer's block. You can unlock the tightest lock if you eat produce, it helps you produce. Sometimes when I try to make art, I choke. So to counteract that, I'll eat an artichoke. Green cabbage, yes. Red cabbage, no. Cause red means stop, but green means go. Watermelon stimulates me if I can't get my lines written, cause the seed spitting simulates rhyme spitting. I eat broccoli, bok choy, and avocados. No room for block, just bok, brock, and guac. Or I'll combine kinds of fruits that rhyme. Persimmons, lemons, limes, clementines, cherries, various berries, apples, pineapples, and apricots. Plus plums and kumquats and pears with green skins, and tangas and nectars, they're the reen twins. I grind them up in that blender of mine, drink down the juice and write some fruit punchlines. Snack peas for my battle rap steez. First I'm like snap, then I'm like peas. Or I eat a radish if my rhymes aren't fully radical yet, only rad-ish. If I'm in a bad mood, cantaloupe and honeydew help me keep a can-do attitude. And when the song is complete, then I eat my two favorite root veggies, the turnip, the beet.
Turn up the beet, turn up the beet, turn up the beet.
Blank pages are as white as chalk. I got nothing coming out, like when people with bronchitis try to talk. Writer's block, and I hate it when my brain is in a constipated state, and that is why I eat all that high-fiber produce. I'm in favor of dropping those creative number twos. I'm saying I'm pro-deuce. We'll be right back.